Hello everyone, I just finished the brand new marble divider and I'm going to test it right now. So the setup is like before, we have the food over here, a treacherous river, and in the end, a hungry Wilson. So the angles for this test is a little bit under 5 degrees in this direction. Then if we switch over to this direction, you can see that the first test is going to be in 25 degrees. I really hope this will be plug and play now. That will be amazing for the Marble Machine X. Let's grab some food. Ooh. So far, no hole have been skipped. We have first marble staying still. Let's see if that resolves itself. It does. Ah, it's great. Wilson, you get food on your nose and in your hair. Super great results. Two occasions marbles got stuck, but it's so little stuck so it fixes itself when the subsequent marbles arrives. This is normal. For us to prove this point, we now have to change the height of all the marbles. I'm going to push these cardboard blockers in, which will make a new configuration for the height. Some I will push out, some I will push in. So the reason I'm doing this is that this marble divider is designed to be height independent, which means that it doesn't matter which height the top marble is. Second test, I changed all the heights. Wilson is hungry again. Let's go. Okay, so we have some marble standing still. You can see some marbles standing still, only one marble resolves the whole issue. And also when the instruments are playing, the marbles go down into the cues. That's also resolving any issues like that. Okay, I'm super happy with the 25 degree result. To me, this is perfect. This would work on the Marble Machine X. I want to try to decrease the angle to maybe 20 and 15 degrees to see if we can find an even better sweet spot where no marbles can get stuck, but they're still falling into each hole. So now I'm going to change this angle, and you can see now we have 26 degrees. I'm just manipulating the clamp here. 20 degrees. Double checking this angle. 4.7. Perfect. Test 320 degrees, the marbles will roll easier. So far the marbles are still hitting each hole, that's good. Okay, already 20 degrees performed better than 25. Nothing got stuck, it just works, 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 even in big groups. So I'm going to again change heights for 20 degrees. So I'm changing the marble height on each channel. 20 degrees, test 2, new marble heights. Okay, so switching to 15 degrees. I've never seen Wilson this happy. Look at him. He's having a blast, a feast. Eternal supply of food. Nom, 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 nom. 15 degrees, test one. I'm going to try to make them stick by releasing a group. Oh, yeah. Ah, look at that. Yeah. 15 degrees, test 2. I want to see when this is too fast, so I've set the angle to 10 degrees. I'm noticing something interesting. When the angle is shallower, it's almost worse because the marbles don't know if they're going into the pocket or not. First of all degrees worked. I had not a single failure in 25, 20, 15 or 10 degrees. It's so cool. In the last video I talked about a big, large tweaking window. I could make the previous design work, but I had to be in one particular thing and it was like shaky. This is redundant. This is stable. This is mature, good engineering design. I'm very, very happy with this because it works in a lot of different setups, right? And what does that tell us? It tells us that it has some redundancy. I don't know why it took me like 4 years to respect redundancy, but I am respecting it now, and that my newborn respect for redundancy will finish the Marble Machine X. So what I noticed in the last test is that when this was tilted forwards, the gravity is pulling the marbles into the pocket with less force, right? I think that is actually making it less smooth. I don't want to do 10 degrees. 20 or 15 was perfect. So 15 degrees is the winner. That's what I'll use for the Marble Machine X. I want to show you how I machined this top PM part and how I integrated it with the plywood divider to make this work. I wanted to be kind of professional when I machined this part. So I started with flattening my CNC bed. I've been experiencing some issues with the CNC not cutting depth correctly everywhere on the parts, and the flattening should prevent that. So this black PUM is really nice to machine, and here I'm cutting ovals on the backside of the piece. So this is a double-sided machining operation, and then I'm cutting the contour. And I've made 3 locating holes, so it's easy to position the part once I flip it soon. Vacuum cleaning in a circle to make it look cool on the time lapse. And here are my 3 locating pins. So I get the part in a perfect position again. Here I'm rough cutting out the bulk of the material, and some plastic decided to throw itself onto the camera, of course. And yeah, you can see these chips. It's really, really nice. Vacuum cleaning in another pattern to make it cool on the time lapse again. And this is the loveliest part. So here I'm having a brand new ball cutter and I'm cutting everything smooth. And this is the final cut, and the result is really, really nice and shiny. I love working with PUM/Delrin. Give me a couple of months and all the plywood on the Marble Machine X is gone. And we have only PUM. So here I'm cutting like a pocket in a piece of scrap wood so I can precisely position this part onto the CNC table. I need to brutally cut the top off to fit our new POM sleeve on top of the old plywood parts. And this fit needs to be super, super accurate. So I'm recutting the depth. I'm checking here with the marbles. Is this good? Is this good? It's really important that the marble groove is continuous from the plywood up into the plastic part for this marble divider to function correctly. I'm just working my way down slowly, 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 and I got things to look really good. And here I'm cutting the last parts. These are 2 extra plywood panels that I'm going to use to attach the PUM to the old plywood parts and also later to the Marble Machine X. So the thin piece here, I'm switching it 180 degrees. I'm cutting a little slope on one side. So these are all the parts. We have 4 plywood parts and 1 POM part to make into a giant marble divider sandwich. So here's that front piece that I cut, and this is just aesthetical to make the PUM part look like it was not an afterthought. And hey, that looks pretty nice, I say. There was some debate on Discord about the PUM color. I was choosing between stained white and black and totally white. And a lot of people wanted black, and Hannes wanted black. And yeah, we have black details already on the machine. And it kind of look kind of engineering with the black. Like Darth Vader's marble divider. So I went with black. And here I'm showing you the very important thing. That there's no gap between the plastics and the marbles. And that is thanks to the fact that I was so careful in cutting the height of the plywood piece on the CNC machine. So Here I'm ready to commit to the position. I'm fastening the POM to the plywood. I was kind of nervous to do that because that was like really final version. And look at this. It looks actually pretty decent. So now I need to make a rail for the front where the marbles can jump out when colliding with each other. I had a similar rail on the old machine and I've actually planned a fastening for this rail in the POM parts. So that should be pretty nice. I'm cutting the parts oversized and then I'm sanding them down to correct length. And here's my three posts and a fence. I'm using the silicone bronze that I wired together into double thickness. And this silicone bronze have a lower melting point than the metal. So when I weld this together, the metal glue melts faster than the rods. I'm holding two points with magnets and I can weld the third point. So I'm changing to a thinner tungsten, so getting rid of this one, and I have a new grounded sharp tip on this one, so that should be clean. Looking sharp. You know when you try to make pancakes, how you fail with the first one and you get the temperature right on the second one? Sometimes it's the same with welding. I went with 20A now for the first weld. I hope we're not going to have a totally failed pancake here. That's a failed pancake. There we go. So I was only paying attention to the weld and the plastic started to melt. I need to weld much hotter to not have the heat spread down to the plastic. So 20 was way too cold. I'm gonna try something like 50 and more to make a tack weld and then the heat doesn't spread down in the metal on the next one. 50 amps, twice as hot. Okay, I'm on my second pancake and containing heat to your weld is really like a pro welding thing that I'm learning. So now I'm trying 80 amps, four times as hot, and hopefully I can do a fast tack weld and the heat is not spreading down into the plastic. Yes, that is nicely done. Let's put it out of the plastic. That was nice. Second pancake, everyone. It's true. Okay, let's put some lemon on our pancake. So we have our fence with three nice fence posts, and my plan for this was to be a press fit. I thought the welding would be inaccurate enough to make this press fit kind of hard, but the welding was too accurate, so the press fit is not hard enough. I am going to just use a little glue to keep things where it is. I couldn't be happier with this result, especially since Wilson is calm and fed and happy now. From this point, I feel super good at ripping the old stuff off the machine and put this on. I feel confident this will work and I'll do that in the next video. Thanks to all the patrons and YouTube members for supporting this crazy journey. I'm feeling great at the moment on where this is going. Have a wonderful day. Nom, nom.